How's it going, everyone? Welcome back to Flamez Plays, and today we're continuing in Night in the Woods, having just went to the mall with me, and now we're going to talk to our dad. What's up, Dad?
Heard you had a wild time last night.
I didn't drink.
It works better if you let me accuse you first.
Right.
Here's my hangover cure. Not drinking the night before.
Wow, hold on. Let me write that down.
It's complicated, I know.
Man, fair enough. I feel like she's 19? She's like 19-20, so I mean it would make sense that he understands she's gonna drink. I mean, being a reasonable parent and not like chewing her out or anything like that. I feel like maybe telling her to be more responsible may have been a good idea, but I'm not a parent yet, so yay. I don't know why I said yay, but here, you talk to me. Hey, cool mall times. Oh, actually, that was actually B. I think I said May earlier. Pretty cool mall times, yes. I hope we didn't make too much of a mess with the fountain. Who's we? I was merely sitting there when I was assaulted with mall water. I will not rest until that fountain is brought to justice. Tell the world my story. They must know. Okay, I'm going to sleep. I hope the nightmares aren't too horrible. It is a trauma I shall bear forever.
Greg!
Hey, dude, what did you do tonight?
Nothing much. Stole something. For Angus.
It's a surprise. Wow, what is it? Hold on for a sec. Oh crap, I gotta go. Talk to you later. Okay, weirdo, you okay? Oh, okay. Kinda weird. Alright, well, we can go to bed now. Bedtime? Yes.
It's still so cute.
Like the little struggle getting the boots off is adorable. Alright. So, brand new day. Let's see what adventures it can bring us. It's a nightmare. Okay. I don't have my bat this time, unfortunately. But I have spooky lights that turn on. And a spooky ghost of what looks like kind of like Greg. Well, let's jump up this way. Oh, I can jump on the these little outlines. If I go this way. I feel like it wants me to go that way. There's also a wire I can walk on here. And it is way faster to jump up. I don't know which way it wants me to go, but I'm gonna scare all these birdos. Yeah. Whoa. There's some weird constellations. I mean, it's a rooftop. Oh. That's a lot of noises I'm hearing. Hi. Can I jump up here and talk to him? No, not really. Well, I guess I'm gonna go over this side. Oh, it's all... Okay. Oh, I get it. We're releasing, like, music. That's the... They're playing the music that's in the background. That's kind of cool. Well, then let's go up on this side. Because we can always drop down pretty easily. Let's see what we got here. Oh, I gotta make this jump, though. I can't mess it up. I didn't mess it up. Yay. He got a little... He got... not a little tuba. He got a tuba. Alright. So where would the other musician be at? Over here. The... violins? Okay. Actually, I want to drop down. I want to drop down. Go down into the spooky area here. There's four pillars, so that was the four people we unlocked. A bear? Oh, my controller's freaking the hell out right now. The rumble is going crazy. It's hard to describe this, but like the rumble actually had like a fade off, like it was slowing down the rumble as it just wasn't just like a hard stop. That was actually pretty cool. I'm glad I played with the controller instead of using the keyboard and mouse. Let's wake up, struggle to put our boots on, struggle to reach our boots, and let's go talk to our mom. I don't know why I thought the photo was teeth now. There's still this stuff here. Yeah, dad put it here, dad should put it over. It's only fair. I kind of want to check out that room, but I don't know when I'll be able to. Alright, let's go talk to our mom, who's chilling in the kitchen here. Gotta pop up on the counter, be like a cool guy. cool kid, girl, 20, it's not a kid anymore. Good morning. Did you feel it last night? What? There was a big sinkhole two streets over. Oh, are we still getting those? I don't think those ever really go away. Swampy ground and so forth and on a floodplain. Oh, weird. I don't want you over there nosing around it. I guarantee you I won't. I have seen sinkholes. No interest at all? Mom, they're just holes in the ground. Get back to me when one, like, swallows a house or something. We'll go see you together if that happens. Deal. So what did you do last night? Went to the mall with B. Oh, Fort Lucene? Yeah. I haven't been there in years. How is it? Kinda falling apart and empty? Yeah, I expect. Everyone just goes to the outlet stores up by the interstate now. Or, you know, shoes and things. Well, stop by the church if you're in the area. Will do, Mom. See ya. Mm-hmm. Bye, sweetie. Aww. I like her family a lot. It's really cute. Like her... So we know that her dad used to go to bars. I'm not sure if that's like... He had a problem or anything like that. Oh, here's a sinkhole. Well, it sure is fall. All the road work crammed in before winter makes like half the town inaccessible. Unless you want to walk the long way around for like 20 minutes, which, I mean, no. Can't jump over his head, damn it. Oh. That's still so weird. Oh, I don't want to stand on cars. That's just being rude. Fences are one thing. Mailboxes, not really sure if they can support her weight, but cars. I don't want to dent them. Wait, let's talk to him. Yeah. Mae Borowski. Selmers. Now, we all know how important it is to look our best. But... Our appearance is the first and sometimes last impression we make. Summers, did you join a cult? Lucky for you, I happen to be a licensed dealer. Oh, okay. Of the Sylvan family of products. Summers, I don't have any money. Oh, okay. Are you giving that pitch to everyone, or have you sold anything yet? Sold some to my mom. And to Abby Krangler. Mrs. Krangler's daughter? Granddaughter. I run into her at the laundromat over by the school. One time, Greg got locked inside one of the tumble dryers. Did he die? He wanted me to start it, but I chickened out. He definitely would have died. Tell him that. He's still mad. Want to hear a poem? Nah, maybe another time. Yeah, let's listen to it. Sometimes, I think and start to sink. Oh no, there's more. Sorry. Then I remember. It's October. October? I can buy my two favorite months. Fall is really nice. It's the best. It is the best. That's my favorite time of year. Look at that. You got spooky pumpkins. You got leaves all going crunch crunch under your feet. You got hot cocoa. Totally reasonable to drink at any time of year, but hot cocoa is way better in fall and in winter. Pumpkin spice everything. I will admit I am the most basic of people, but I will gladly drink pumpkin spice whenever I get the chance. What am I doing? What am I trying to do? Oh, Greg, I want to talk to Greg. Because Greg was telling me something, and then he had to leave. So I want to make sure he's okay. Because I mean, B we already know. Angus we don't really talk too much about, it seems. But Greg, he's like our best friend. Jump over the trash can for style. There's the bar again. There you go, Snack Falcon. Has he got cups on his ears again? No, he doesn't. Oh, I like the cups on his ears. Hey, Mae. Totally. What's up, dude? Was thinking about going to jail. Like, you're planning on going? Like, you're afraid of going? Yeah, like, you're planning on going? I think I could break out. Maybe I should, like, test my skills of escape. I feel like the risk is bigger than any possible reward. Yeah. What brought this up? I had a nightmare about going to jail. My cousin went to jail. My other cousin, Jen, said it was inevitable. Oh man, you're not inevitable. I mean, it's not inevitable. No, go back. I am definitely inevitable. The inevitable Greg. Is Angus around today? Nah, he's off doing some stuff. What stuff? Family stuff. They're not worth talking about. Yeesh. You wanna hang out? Got a lot to do. Yeah, man, let's roll. Yeah, let's hang out with Greg. We haven't hung out with Greg alone since we moved back in. Damn straight. What does Greg do for fun? Mechanics. Okay. Is it? Oh, all right. The bullet went clean through. You can still see the bullet hole in it. How did that not kill him? He must have missed all the important parts of the brain. Wow. Yeah, great-great-granddad was pretty tough. But isn't that the helmet the fascists were wearing? Ugh, no, wrong war. And wrong country. These weren't the bad guys. Read some history. Jeez, okay. When did you learn all this stuff? When people kept saying it was a fascist hat. So what are we doing? You up for a crime? Boy, am I ever. I mean, I kind of did some last night. Oh, really? Without me? Aw, dude. You're always my number one crime friend. That's beautiful, dude. Likewise. So what's the plan? Follow me? Yes, dear leader. I am both a leader and a deer. No, you're a fox, dude. Rain sure cleared up. Weather moves for us. So what do I need the bat for? I'm just gonna smash the car. Ta-da! Ooh la la. F that car up, Private Borowski. So, you brought me out here to watch me beat up a car, or why? Yeah, you brought me out here to watch me beat up a car. Well, okay. Is that this like that thing where people are all hot for car crashes? It's a thing? No, and I don't know that movie. Look it up. Eh. So we need the battery out of this car. What for? That's privilege info, Private. Stop calling me Private. I'm a general at least, or I ain't in your army. I'm a general at least. No, I'm the general. I got a hat. War is stupid. Watch it. War got me this hat. Okay, but what if someone needs this car? I think it's safe to say no one's gonna miss it. Yeah, I guess it's got a tree growing through it. So we're just beating it until the hood pops open, or why aren't you helping? Why aren't you helping? I'm carrying the battery all the way back. Division of labor. You get the fun part anyways. True. Yeah, just smash it up. Smash it all up. Smash capitalism. Smash the government. Smash this car. Yarrrrrrr. Blammo, kabah. Yeah, destroy the fascist car. Onward, revolution. Yarrrrr. I mean, the hood's just popping up. We can just lift it up. Your time has come, car. Say your prayers, car. Do whatever gods, ghost tiger vampires rise from the moon. Blood, give me blood. No, just, what if I hit him? No, I can't hit him. The final blow. What am I doing? Why am I? I don't think that smashing the glass is really gonna help too much, but you know, maybe this will help. Maybe this will do some things. No, it doesn't really seem to do it. Excellent work. Thank you, I agree. You wanna do the honors? Am I gonna get electrocuted? Should be fine. The car's got a tree growing through it. Probably not electric anymore. Wait, but do you want to do it or not? I do. Yeah, that battery's probably dead. Okay, so just grab one of the wires and yank it off. Thanks, I think I can figure it out. Gotta get rid of these leaves first. Brush them out of the way. Yep, okay, go brush all the leaves out. All right, so let's go ahead and grab this one. This one. This, can I grab? Ow! Oh, I got shocked. Yarg! Wow! Did I die? God, is that you? Sharkle! Hey, Sharkle. What are you doing here? We've been through so much together, Mae. The good times, the bad times, the porn adware fiasco. That weekend you tried to change the operating system. You're right. We have been through a lot together. Sharkle, am I dead? Yes! Are you here to take me to the other side? Yes, as in the old legends. Your soul has been swayed against your transgressions. Oh, how did that turn out? Could have gone better. Oh, frig. I'm sorry, but it's off to hell for you. Dang. Mae Borowski, I declare thee danged. Oh well. You're in good company. Lots of folks been danged. I regret nothing. Hee hee. What? Ha ha ha. Dude. Ha 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 ha. I think it's Greg. Ha 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 ha. Ugh. Oh shit. You okay? I think I died. How long was I out? Like 5 seconds? Oh, weird. I'm like stretches. It's a mysterious universe. We good to go with the battery? You know it. Let's get back to the apartment. I taste pennies. Not what I read the first time I said that. Or, not what I read the first time I read that. And anyway, even if it was a fascist helmet, it's got an anarchy symbol on it now, which makes it good. And there's a bullet hole in it, so whoever was wearing it is dead. And I'm like, wearing the trophy. You just said it was your grandfather's and he was shot in the helmet and he didn't die from the bullet. It missed the brain, the good parts of the brain, apparently. So you admit that's a fascist helmet? No, I don't. Okay. So what are we doing? Okay, so, wait, question. Shoot. What the hell is that? The thing? Yes, obviously the thing. Remember those big robot cartoon characters they used to have at the Food Donkey? I do. Oh my god, is that one of them? Are we gonna put one of them together? Dude, we totally are. This is amazing! Where the hell did you get it? You know Steve Scriggins? Let's see. There you go, the guy who drove little circles around people in the school parking lot. So they were trapped, called it car camp, and he'd blast one of those air horns at you? Yeah, that guy. He's horrible, man. But he's been hanging out at the Food Donkey since it's been shut down, and he dug it out for me. That is the first useful thing Steve has ever done. Okay, 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 okay. What do? We need to get this old battery into that thing, old thing. Well, this sounds straightforward enough. Kinda. It's full of garbage. It's too bad you didn't cut yourself on it and get the disease. It's too bad you didn't die on the way here. It's too bad that I technically did kind of die on the way here. I got shocked by the battery. Don't think I actually died, but I got knocked out. It's too bad the robot wasn't filled with angry snakes and it killed you. It's too bad the elevator didn't fall and squash you like a pancake. Oh, dude, no, that's a phobia. That's one that makes sense, at least. Okay, what were we doing again? I completely lost track, too. Something about building an animatronic that's going to have a baby's, child's soul in it or something. Oof, this thing smells. That's just how old machines smell. No, like, I think something was living in here. Uh-oh.
Hey, I've got an idea. Why don't you stop being so negative? Why don't you eat your own neck?
That's impossible. Be serious, could a giraffe eat its own neck? I actually wonder that now. How flexible are giraffes' necks? I think I do think I remember seeing footage of like one whipping its head back and forth, but I don't know if it could bite its own neck because of the whole vertebrae thing. This is serious business. Oh well. Well, don't mind me. See, I've already died once tonight. No big deal or anything. What was that like? I saw a shark, I think. I could taste my tooth fillings. Actually, yeah, I could taste my tooth fillings. And it's like they're ringing? Ringing? Like little bells inside my skull. Wow. Yeah. Okay, let's do this. Clamp it. It's so cute the way that they're using the alligator clips to pretend they're talking. It's like it's such a little thing that's just cute. Jeez. That looks safe. Are you gonna be all boring now just because you died for like a whole 5 seconds? Dude, come on. Some people have been dead for like forever. Do you see them whining? Right. They either shut up and deal, or they become ghost. Are you saying I should become a ghost? Yeah, carpe diem. Close enough. Carpe diem. Carpe diem sounds like a fish. Carpe diem, yeah. Oh, look who's all fancy in French now. It's okay. That's fine. We'll just let that slide, Greg. Okay, fine. What are we doing? Now is the best part. We're gonna put this beast together. Do you know how it goes together? Gotta find out. Cool. May? Sorry. Cool. Woo! Oh! Oh god, there's a game. Now here are all the parts. Wow, so many possible combinations. We can create our own unique metal offspring. So we just clank these together? Yeah, slap them together, tighten some screws. What could go wrong? I mean, quite a lot. Lots of times stuff goes wrong. Dude, you are no fun. I literally just died. All right, well, first things first, let's go ahead and pop this thing. Oh, wait, do I want to pop? Wait, I'm kind of confused. Okay, I can do this. Got it. I understand now. Then we want to give him some legs, of course. Yep, this is good. Oh, wait, actually, no, these aren't legs. These are the opposite side. There you go, so we give him arms. Now we give him legs on this side. We're gonna pop this on here. Gotta give him feces. Oop. Little tiny footsies. And then, I mean, obviously we have to give him a knife. Because, I mean, why wouldn't she at that point? I don't know what this is, but I'm gonna assume it's like a cannon. And we give him a head. And we have nailed it, I think. Let's see what our monstrosity looks like. He's beautiful. He's perfect. Our beautiful boy. Our robot son. So, like, this is pretty great and all, but remind me, why do we just put a bunch of garbage together in your living room and connect it to a stolen car battery that's already leaking acid on the carpet, I think? I don't know. Since you've been back in town, I think I missed Greg of a few years ago. Hmm? Like, these days I mostly work all the time, but why are you working so much? We got plans. What plans? Bright Harbor. Bright Harbor? Since when? A year or so now? That's why we're working like 7 days a week. But when are you moving? I think in the spring? That's like a few months away. Yeah. Oh, okay. You should come visit when we get settled in. Why Bright Harbor? Isn't Bright Harbor like really expensive? Yeah. Not if you live in a terrible neighborhood. Oh man, it's so cool. We visit in the summer. There's like record stores and weird bars and everyone's cool and like free. Oh, so Portland. Got it. That's where I got my tattoo. What? Yeah. Okay, it's just a sheep. Is that a sheep? Yep. Why a sheep? The tattoo guy was like all the way hot and it didn't even hurt. That didn't answer the question of why a sheep, but all right. You have a tattoo. You're moving to Bright Harbor. Yeah? Oh, okay. All right, anyway. Yeah, like I was saying, now that you're back in Possum Springs, I was like, hey, let's do some crimes again. Oh, dude. Yep. So I was thinking about how to use that for, like, good. So I thought I'd bring this here for Angus. That's beautiful, dude. I'm sure he'll love it. I hope so. Okay, so, yeah, all we need to do now is turn it on. Oh, I want to push the button. Let me push the button. Let me do it. Dude, it's the least I could do for my best friend back from the dead. Pizza party next time I die and come back. Dude, that is such a deal. Sweet. Oh, we're going to turn the animatronic on, which I'm going to do in the next episode. I hope you're all enjoying this series. And if you are, let me know in the comments down below. You can kind of see some of the things that Mae's going through, coming back and hope and expecting it to be all the same way she left it when she finds out that her friends are planning on leaving at some time in the near future. Or like B is currently working hard and trying to keep her family's business afloat after both of her parents passed away. I think at least I know her mom passed away. I'm not sure about her dad, but it's a weird way of growing up. I'm liking the story and how it's being delivered really well. Let me know what you think in the comments down below. Give me a thumbs up. I really do appreciate that. And also make sure you're subscribed to get updates and release new content or go live while live streaming. And as always, have a great day. Remember to burn bright. I'll talk to you later. Bye.